Solving equations by factoring. GCFs as factoring. When solving, do not forget that the GCF is a factor as well. GCF, our greatest common factor that we pull out, that's also a factor, so we need to set that equal to zero. If there is no variable in the GCF, then we can ignore it. It's not really going to help us to solve for x if there's no x in the GCF. So, let's go ahead and look at this example 1. So in example 1, we've got 4x to the third minus 12x squared equals 40x. So the first thing that I'm noticing here is that I really need to move everything over to one side of the equation and set it equal to 0, because there's stuff on both sides here. So my highest exponent here is actually a cubed, so I think I'm going to keep everything on this side with my highest exponent. We'll see how that works out. So let's go ahead and subtract 40x from both sides. And then we'll have 4x to the third minus 12x squared minus 40x equals 0. Very nice. So now I'm noticing that all of these coefficients are multiples of 4. So I'm thinking I'm going to pull out a 4. And then the next thing that's going to happen is I'm seeing that I've also got an x in common in all of these. So I'm going to pull out an x. Okay, so then we have to take each of these terms and divide it by 4x. So that'll leave me with just an x squared for my first term, minus 3x for my middle term, and minus 10 for my last term. Set that equal to 0. So now I've done the first step of factoring, pulling out this GCF, but I haven't completely factored yet. Remember, we still have to check the inside parentheses and see if we can break it down any farther. So now we're going to do 4x, another set of two parentheses right here. So I'm going to have an x and an x to multiply together to give me this x squared. Then I want something that will multiply together to give me 10 and subtract to give me negative 3. So I'm thinking negative 5 and positive 2. Multiply gives me negative 10. Add them together gives me negative 3. Cool. So now I have three different factors multiplied together give me 0. So I'm going to have three possible solutions. Each factor set equal to 0 is going to give me one of my solutions. Okay, so looks like x equals 0 is one of my solutions. And here if I add 5 to both sides, that'll come up with x equals 5 is another solution. Oop, equals 0. And so this one, when I subtract 2 from both sides, I come up with x equals negative 2 is another solution. So here, including the factor that I got from my GCF, I'm going to have three different solutions to this equation. So now let's go ahead and look at example 2. So in example 2, I've got, again, some stuff on each side of the equation. My x squared is over on this side, and it's positive, so I want to keep it positive. I'll move everything else over to the same side, keep it positive. Minus 36 plus 15x. Okay, so 6x squared plus 15x minus 36 equals 0. Okay, so now next thing that I'm noticing is that these are all multiples of 3. So that's going to be the GCF that I can pull out. So I'll have a 3 out in front, and I want to divide each of these terms by 3. So I'll get 2x squared plus 5x minus 12 equals 0. Okay, so then this one, got to remember, keep factoring. Bring down my 3, then I'll have a set of 2 parentheses here. So I know that to multiply to this 2x squared, that 2x and x would be very useful. Then I want to figure out what I can multiply to give me this minus 12. So I'm going to try minus 3 and plus 4. So then let's check that, and if we did 2x times 4, we would get 8x, and my inside terms, minus 3x, 8x minus 3x would give me my 5x win. So, we've now successfully factored this, and we have 3 different terms equals 0. So, what we have in our notes from up above is that if the GCF doesn't have a variable in it, then we can ignore it. This is just a number, so we can just ignore that one. So now I've got 2 factors that I can actually set equal to 0. 2x minus 3 equals 0, and x plus 4 equals 0. Okay, so plus 3, plus 3, 2x equals 3, minus 4, minus 4, x equals negative 4. Oops, this one's not done yet. Okay, so x equals 3 halves is one of our solutions, or x equals negative 4 is our other solution.